I'll be sharing 6 no-code tools that speed up different parts of the app development process and together address a significant portion of the journey. I'm just going to give you the list right now. Stories on board to generate first iteration of user stories. Mobin to get inspired by a massive gallery of reusable app design templates. Galileo to generate web and mobile screens with AI that can be exported to Figma. Wizard to enjoy robust and non-tech friendly UI design features. Backendless Schema AI to generate and iterate custom backend schemas with AI. Zapier to be explicitly told what third-party integration your app needs. If you prefer to explore them yourself, links are in the description. Keep watching if you'd like to see me go over these tools in detail and how they can help you build your next app faster than last time. Oh, and a mini rant at the end. You've seen this guy. Only 400 tools? Those are rookie numbers, man. Uncle Adrian simultaneously exists in the past, present, and future. And I've tried every no-code tool that will ever exist. And as of 2024, there are 6 that I think can benefit almost every non-tech founders out there, whether you're working solo, as a part of the team, or with developers. The first one, Stories on Board. What it speeds up? User story generation. If you're new to this, let me quickly explain what a user story is and why it's so valuable. Most of the time, you don't get just an idea for an app and go straight into building. In between, there's a step called requirements gathering, where you find out what the project will need to succeed, including preparing user stories. A user story is a short description of a feature from a user's perspective. In agile software development, user stories describe the requirements the software must deliver. A user story consists of persona, action, and outcome. Simple enough, but each function gets its own user story. And there can be a lot of stories depending on the app. If you write everything from scratch, user stories can take days to work out because you're constantly trying to put yourself in the user's shoe. Stories on board can turn this vital but time-consuming step into just a vital step. Describe the app you're trying to build and it will generate a comprehensive board of user stories grouped by category. You can even keep using stories on board to prioritize these features and add timelines and basically be your product roadmap. But that's up to you. I think the auto-generated user stories alone is a godsend. Okay, the next 3 tools are all to do with design, starting with number 2, Mobin. What it speeds up? Finding great first draft app design. This one is not AI, but it's so useful I had to include it. Mobin is a UI library that claims to have over 300,000 screens from the world's best apps. Do they really have that many? Well, every time I start counting, I fall asleep before I finish. So who knows? Point is, they have a lot, both in terms of quality and quantity. So whenever we start a project, my designers go straight to Mobin in search of inspiration, and you can take entire app or specific screens, elements like buttons and navigation bars, and flows like the password reset I've mentioned before. You can download them as PNG files or export directly to Figma. If you're the type that cares extremely deeply about design, or more importantly, if your target audience does, Mobin is a great resource to quickly find the base of a great looking design. Also, if you ever work with designers, this will save you a ton of stress trying to tell them what you want. With Mobin, you can just show it to them. You know, some people say that the real tools that help app development are the YouTube channels you subscribe to along the way. So if you found this video useful and would like to see more content like it, please subscribe and leave a like. Number 3, Galileo. What it speeds up? Generating your own original first draft app interface. Galileo actually got a tiny shout out on an old video of mine, also about no-code tools. At the time, it was still in beta testing, and I think it had a waiting list of like 6,000 people. I signed up, but never got a call. I was absolutely devastated. But now, they're up and running, and apparently, they can help you create web and mobile interfaces at lightning speed. According to Google, lightning moves at 270,000 miles per hour, So that's really impressive. Galileo has an AI-powered text-to-design feature where you can describe your app in plain language and get designs auto-generated in seconds. You can then copy them into Figma or continue editing using more AI prompts. I think that Galileo and Mobin complement each other extremely well. Mobin is if you want to be inspired by great existing designs. Galileo is if you want to create something new and already slightly more tailored to your needs. And in both cases, they go right up into Figma. But let's say you don't want to deal with Figma. Here's a long time favorite of mine. Number four, Wizard. What it speeds up? General UI design for non-tech folks. I'm historically bad at dealing with French stuff, and a year later, I still don't know whether it's Wizard or UIZard. And knowing me, it's probably neither. But ever since I came across it a year ago, Wizard has been my go-to suggestion for non-technical folks who need a platform to work on wireframing and mockup designs. The main thing about it is you have a Galileo-like AI interface generation, which you can then edit on Wizard itself without having to mess with Figma. In fact, that's what Wizard is for. It's a less technically demanding version of Figma. In addition to text-based AI generation, you can also turn your screenshots and pictures into digital design. I have no idea how they do that, but they're called Wizard, so it could just be Wizardy. Either way, I think it's an amazing collection of features because now you can just sketch stuff out and turn that into a mockup. And it's not a huge deal for me, but Wizard also comes with a built-in heat map feature to predict where on the screen users' attention will be focused. With no information on how accurate it is or the training data, I wouldn't go all in on it. But it's a cool extra feature to have if you want to do A/B testing for elements and layouts. Also, for what it's worth, even though my team and I use Figma, I acknowledge Wizard's interface is just way more intuitive. Okay, so that was three design focus tools in a row. Now for app development with number five, backendless and schema AI. What it speeds up? Your no-code backend architecture. For non-tech founders who outgrow built-in no-code backends or need to use an app builder without one, they need a dedicated no-code backend. So now you're working with two platforms, and you are working on connecting these two platforms. There's a lot of great options for dedicated no-code backends, and they all edge each other out in specific ways. Xano is easier to use, Supabase is more extendable, and backendless comes with AI assistance. Specifically, just as you prompt Galileo or Wizard's AI generator to make your front-end designs, you could do the same with backendless where you tell it what you need and it will create a database schema based on your requirements. From there, of course, you can keep prompting the AI and it will adjust the schema accordingly until you're satisfied. To be clear, a schema isn't your actual backend. It's a blueprint of how your database should be organized and connected so you don't get lost among the many options. So backendless schema AI gives you a solid plan of action so you can focus on execution. And notice that this entry is both backendless and their AI features, not just their AI feature. Backendless by itself is already a very robust platform that can speed up no-code backend development for non-tech founders. Their schema AI is the icing on the cake that complements backendless and makes it even faster and easier to develop your backend. Okay, last entry, also closely related to backend no-code development. Number six, Zapier AI. What it speeds up? Coming up with your list of integrations and final tech stack. I don't think Zapier needs any introduction. It's an extremely popular tool to connect no-code apps to third-party service providers to add additional functionality to your product. Zapier is not the only one offering this. There are many alternatives like Make and Integrately. And I think just like with backendless and company, each comes with their own USPs. And just like with backendless, if speed is your priority, I recommend checking out Zapier because of their AI integration. To me, it's a textbook perfect use case for AI. Zapier was already a great product that caters to non-technical folks. And now you can just describe the kind of data flows and interactions you need, and Zapier AI will suggest zaps that can make it happen in seconds. Zapier by itself already helps speed up software development, and Zapier AI helps make it even faster. Okay, so there you go. Six amazing tools that will help you speed up every part of app development and app development as a whole. I said 10x though, and what do you get when you multiply by zero? Well, you get a big, fat, juicy zero.
zero.
And in case it isn't obvious, it's Uncle Adrian's time to rant. Okay, rant is a strong word. It's more of a word of advice. No code already lowers the barrier to entry when it comes to app development. Generative AI integration has lowered it even more. But I don't see them the same way. No code removed the need to code. Definitely a good thing. AI has removed the need to think. Potentially a terrible thing. Just because you can now instantly create app interfaces and backend schemas with a description does not mean you don't need to know what they are, what they do, and how they work. Because AI is not a miracle. My team and I tried out an AI coding assistant called Loco5 for a while, and we found that the stuff it was producing wasn't ideal for us, because we knew what good enough was. If you start with AI doing everything for you, I think something important gets lost along the way. A writer could call it character development, a HR manager would call it personal growth. I'll call it wisdom. So as you use this tool, use them wisely. Also, you might have noticed there's no front-end app builder tool in this list. Intentional. I've done so many videos dedicated to them, I wanted to use this chance to share more specific tools. But make no mistake, your front-end no-code app builder is arguably your most important tool, so I recommend watching my app builder tier list where I rank 19 no-code web app builders, and you're bound to find something that fits your need. Thanks for watching, please subscribe and leave a like, and till this time, baby.